Okay, now the other day I made my video about the Titanic because I didn't think I'd be able to make the video today to honor the Titanic. Well, I made the video the other day, it's uploaded. I am able to make a video today and talk about other things, but I will acknowledge this is the 100th anniversary. Now, first things first, I made a video, I'm gonna see if I can drop it below, about Mitt Romney. And my hollow point gave the best comment. So I said to him, I said, you win the best comment award. So I'm giving my hollow point the shout out because his comment was so good. Wasn't as good as I would have done it, but not everybody can be me. I have better comments, he has better guns. You decide who won that contest. Anyway, I want to acknowledge my hollow point. He's a cool guy. He's got a lot of nice shit. Go check him out. I also want to acknowledge, we're talking about gun confiscation and gun law today. We're talking about gun confiscation today. I want to acknowledge my buddy Speed Dog. Speed Dog lives in a county that is worse than my county. My county looks like Texas compared to his county. Speed Dog finally got his handgun license. So in honor of Speed Dog, we're going to get drunk tonight. Speed Dog made a video the other day, I'm going to drop it in the link too. It is a federal law. When you buy a shotgun with the pistol grip and no buttstock, you must be 21. You could be 18 to buy a shotgun, but if the shotgun has a pistol grip instead of a buttstock, you must be 21. I did not know that, he did not know that. And the moral of today's story is, you don't know every gun law. Even me, who is considered a god among laws, I am the god of gun law. I, too, may fuck up. I may not know something. So we're going to thank Speed Dog, and we're going to drop Speed Dog's video in the link, too. We're also going to drop in the link, if I can find it, an NRA video series from a few years ago about the People's Republic of Comrade Fornia. Now, Comrade Fornia, we're talking about gun confiscation today. Comrade Fornia implemented their gun bans in 1989, before the federal government. In fact, the federal government laws were sort of, kind of based on them. Now, anti-gun politicians, number one characteristic, they're all hypocrites. Some of them own guns, all of them have bodyguards, and because we're talking about Comrade Fornia, let's talk about Senator Dianne Feinstein, who carries a gun everywhere she goes. It is very important to understand that because she is a hypocrite. She publicly said she wants guns confiscated, but not hers. Now, New York's law, keep in mind the federal ban is up for, the weapons accessory bans are being appealed in federal court in California on April 20th. We'll see how that works out. And there's a New York case on the state level pending soon. We'll see how that works out too. New York State's ban, let's talk about rifles, must be semi-automatic. It has to fit into all these categories. Must be semi-automatic. You can have a bolt action or a pump action or a lever action rifle with a bayonet lug, pistol grip, collapsible buttstock, flash hider. It's okay. Must be semi-automatic, and must have a detachable box magazine that is fit, that can hold more than 5 rounds. Now, the Ruger Mini 14, which I will buy, has 5 rounds, 10 rounds, 20 rounds, 30 rounds, 40 rounds, and if you look real hard, 100 rounds. You gotta look real hard for that one. The Mini 14 does not count because I can physically put a large magazine in. Now, Sega does make some rifles and shotguns. I've seen them on documentaries where the gunsmith says this Sega shotgun holds 2 rounds, this Sega rifle holds 5 rounds. No pistol grip, no bayonet lug, no none of that bullshit. They're sporting rifles and they physically cannot hold more than 5 rounds. You cannot put a 30-round magazine in. Therefore, that Sega doesn't count in New York because I physically cannot feed a larger capacity magazine than 5 rounds in. Okay. And is manufactured after September 13th, 1994. So, Vietnam veterans brought back AK-47s from the Vietnam War. Do it. So Vietnam veterans brought back AK-47s. They brought them home. They stamped them. New York State does not honor machine guns. So, a Vietnam veteran wants to sell me his AK-47 that he got from a Viet Cong that he killed. I take it to a gunsmith. And I have a gunsmith convert it from full automatic to semi-automatic. He documents that for me. So it's not a machine gun. It's a semi-automatic gun now. Made before 1994. Okay, I can put collapsible buttstock, bayonet lug, pistol grip, flash hider on that gun. Because the gun is stamped before 1994. Therefore, no restrictions. I can put anything I want on there. Now, magazine. A Gulf War veteran confiscated a 100 round drum magazine from an Iraqi in 1991, which is before 1994, in case you can't count. I buy that. So I have an AK-47 that is semi-automatic, made before 1994, collapsible buttstock, pistol grip, bayonet lug, flash suppressor, everything on it. 100 round drum magazine made in 1980s, brought back to America in 1991. I put that on there. 100% legal. There's no law against people in my state that physically had it before the ban, and there's no law against buying pre-ban items or pre-ban guns and putting new items on them. You can't have a new magazine, but you can have a new buttstock on an old gun. Okay? Yeah. We'll get into this in a minute. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Now, in California, in 1989, they started banning this gun, that gun, that gun, that gun. Now, they look for politicians that know nothing about guns at all. We have a congresswoman in Long Island, New York, who told Tucker Carlson on Fox News that a barrel shroud is a thing that comes up to your shoulder. Her husband was killed, her son was injured, in a train shooting in the early 90s, and she holds every gun owner responsible. She looks at me the same way she looks at her husband's killer. It's very sad. They look for people that don't know anything about guns. They look for people that are brainwashed against guns and gun owners, okay? They're not gonna have me, Chuck Norris, and Lima Life's husband write gun laws. They're gonna have Dianne Feinstein, Rosie O'Donnell, and Joe Biden write gun laws. They won't pay Rosie in cash, they'll pay her in fried chicken. So that's who they get to write the gun laws. Anybody prejudiced against the gun. Comprende? Now in California, this guy wrote a law, 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 this law overlapped this, overlapped that, overlapped that, overlapped that. Okay? So because of that, people don't know what the fuck to do. They don't know, like, it's not clear. Like, in New York State, it's clear. Okay? I just said, if the gun is made before 1994, I can put anything I want on it. If the magazine is made before 94, it can have a collapsible buttstock. It can have anything it wants on it. No, if the magazine is made before 94, it can have 1,000 rounds in it. Okay? New York, it has to be semi-auto, has to have a box magazine that is physically capable of holding more than 5 rounds, has to be manufactured after September 13th of 94, and is allowed to have one evil feature. So if it's made before 94, you can have all the evil features on it, okay? That is clear. And I have the penal code to look at. And because this one is a year out of date, I can get a new penal code or look online. But that is clear and concise, and I can look at it and I can understand it. California's penal code is so fucked up, you'll see in the documentary, that the judges, sheriffs, commissioners, mayors, governors, police officers, they themselves do not know what the law is because the law is so fucked up. A police officer said in that documentary, and you will see it, the officer said, if I go into my precinct and I show my officers an illegal gun and a legal gun, less than 1% will know the difference. So that creates confusion. And you can have a guy in California who has a gun, he thinks it's legal, and maybe it was legal the day he bought it, but now it's not legal. So he's a convicted felon now. That's how fucked up things are. It's very, very hard for you to stay within the boundaries. And you are required as a gun owner to know the law. But if you have laws that are so fucked up that judges can't understand them, how are you going to understand them? Now, this is about gun confiscation. There was a gentleman who was a military veteran. I think he was retired from the Air Force as a pilot and a civilian pilot. He moved to California. Now, with all due respect to him as a veteran, I cannot fathom why anyone would want to move to California now. Even if you're not a gun owner. But he did. He moved to California. Now he had an SKS rifle. Now, the SKS rifle does not have a detachable box magazine. It has a 10 round internal fixed magazine, and I top load 10 rounds of 7.62 by 39 in the top. Same ammo as the AK-47. But it physically cannot hold more than 10 rounds. Okay? Now, New York State, the SKS rifle was made before the AK-47. They're all old school military surplus rifles. New York does not recognize anything made before the ban as an assault weapon. So the SKS rifle is not an assault weapon. Now, because it has 10 rounds top fed and does not have a detachable box magazine, it is also not an assault weapon. So if a company makes a brand new SKS, let's assume that a rifle company makes a brand new SKS. I can buy that, put a bayonet lug pistol grip and collapsible buttstock on it, and it's not an assault rifle because it doesn't have a 10 round, it doesn't have a detachable box. It has an internal thing. The M1 Garand is not an assault rifle. The M1 Garand top loads 8 rounds. Let me tell you something right now. I'd rather get shot 3 times with an AR than 1 time with a Garand. A Garand will cut you in half. Stupid people, right? So New York State would not recognize the SKS as an assault rifle by any means. Now California, this guy's moving out there. He talked to, I think, Attorney General, or he talked to high-ranking officials in California. May I take this rifle there? Yes, you may. The SKS rifle is legal in California. Now, he bought the rifle 20 years before this happened. And the rifle must have been manufactured, what, 30 or 40 years before that? One day he gets a knock on the door from the police. Sir, the SKS is now illegal. We have to confiscate it from you. Wait a minute. It wasn't illegal when he bought it. It wasn't illegal when he moved it into the state, but it's illegal now. In New York State, if you write a law today, but I have the gun today, it's good. I can't buy it tomorrow, but if I have it today and you write the law today, I'm clean. Not so out in California. They sent a police officer to take his rifle from him. This is a military veteran who has no criminal record and has done nothing visibly wrong. Weapon was confiscated from him. As far as I'm concerned, that is an infringement of his Second Amendment right. Because in order for a police officer to take your weapon from you, he has to be able or should be able to prove that you are dangerous. You beat the shit out of your wife. You attempted suicide. You were a full-blown alcoholic and you drive drunk and you hear voices in your head telling you to shit in the salad bar at Wendy's, okay? They need to have proof that you are dangerous before they confiscate your guns. And I've seen gun confiscation in New York. A few years ago, there was a man who picked up the phone, called his ex-girlfriend, and left a threatening message on her answering machine. A judge said, I consider that domestic violence because you threatened a former lover. You threatened her. Give me your license. Give me all your guns. You will never own a gun ever again as long as I sit on the bench. That is an individual situation with an individual who committed a crime. He made a threat against someone. He should have had his gun taken away. Now, this gentleman has done no crime. He even checked with the law enforcement officials before bringing his gun into the state and registering it with the state. But now, because a new law has been written, you take it from him. That is gun confiscation, and it is wrong. And it has happened. Now, continuing our story, New York City. New York City has a ban. Believe me, okay? You think New York State is bad. If I bring somebody from New York City into here, they'll think they're in Texas. They can't get over how good our gun laws and knife laws are. They can't get over how good they are. I saw a thing recently about New York City. It was over 20 years ago, but I just found out about it recently, so I'm telling you now. New York City defines any evil feature. New York State will say, if the, like I said, semi-automatic rifle, magazine that holds more than 5 rounds, made after 94, it's allowed one evil feature. New York City, no evil features. New York City, no grandfather clause. New York City, no nothing. Okay? New York City bans barrel shrouds. Remember the thing that comes to the shoulder? New York City bans barrel shrouds. New York State does not. New York State has a restriction on the bayonet lug of a rifle, not of a shotgun. I can buy an automatic shotgun in New York State and put a bayonet on it. Not a rifle, a shotgun. New York City does not allow that. Now, New York State would say, listen, from now on, if you're buying a rifle with these characteristics, make sure it was made before 12:03 p.m. today. Not New York City. New York City said, these are the rifles that are now illegal. New York City, no AR, period. No AK, period. List of rifles and shotguns this long. Banned entirely, no questions asked, period. So New York City said, these rifles are now banned. If you have one, you have 90 days to surrender it. New York City registers long guns. New York State does not. New York City said, we will be doing spot checks. Now, keep in mind, in the early 90s, New York City was more violent than it is now. Now, this is me talking, okay? I have a problem. I pick up the phone, I dial 911. Okay? If I find out that a patrol officer could not come to rescue me because that patrol officer was confiscating guns from law-abiding citizens, let me tell you something, my friend. Me, you, the Second Amendment Foundation, and the NRA are gonna have a problem with a federal judge. Okay? I am gonna physically take the entire state to federal court. I'll go right to the NRA, Second Amendment Foundation, I'll get lawyers, I'll lobby. I pick up the phone and I call 911. If I can't get the cop because the cop is helping a rape victim, that's fine. But if I can't get the cop because the city sent the cop to confiscate a gun from a law-abiding citizen, I'm suing you in federal court. And I'll lose the case, but I'll sue you just to make a statement. Spot check. What the fuck with spot checks? Why don't you spot check the drug dealers and gangbangers and fucking terrorists? Spot check. Spot check. Spot check. So they confiscated the guns. Keep in mind, this is before England confiscated the guns. Now, the Attorney General of California, and oh, by the way, speaking of California, the Walther 22 handgun, they told the people in California, the gun dealers in California, the 22 Walther handgun has a feature we don't like. It's now banned. Don't sell it anymore. Send the guns you have in the back to the factory and ask for your money back. You're not going to sell them. California didn't say any gun manufactured after today is banned. They said the gun is banned. Send it back. Don't sell it. California has, I don't know if they still have it, but they had it a while ago. The Attorney General of California has a power. he can ban any gun he wants for any reason he wants, any time he wants, and he does not have to answer to any committee, any legislator, the governor, the mayor, the commissioner, the police commissioner, the sheriff, okay? The Attorney General of California has the right to ban a gun, period, no questions asked. That's a dictatorial power. Because he doesn't have the consent of the governed. Also, New York City, the police commissioner of New York City has the power. He can ban any rifle he wants for any reason he wants, any time he wants, no questions asked. And the police commissioner, whether it's today or 50 years from now, the police commissioner is appointed by the mayor. That's how it works, okay? The sheriff, okay? You live in a county that has a sheriff. You elect the sheriff. And if you don't like him, in November, you vote his ass out like any other politician. Police commissioners are appointed by the mayor. I elect my mayor, my Democrat, conservative, pro-gun mayor. He appoints a police commissioner. And the commissioner obeys him. So if you have an anti-gun mayor, Bloomberg, he can get an anti-gun police commissioner. Now, a few years ago, they wanted to give that power to the colonel of the New York State Police. That means the colonel of the New York State Police would have the power to ban any gun he wanted, anytime he wanted, no questions asked, period. No one even voted on it. Okay, now, my cousin. If my cousin becomes the colonel of the state police one day, my cousin supports the Second Amendment. Therefore, my cousin will not ban anything. In fact, on the contrary, if you give my cousin dictatorial power, he'll abolish the weapons accessories ban. He will. But let's assume that the colonel of the state police is not as cool as my cousin. Let's assume he's an anti-gun person. And believe me, they would find anti-gun people to put in. That anti-gun person can ban anything he wants. It's a dictatorial power. Our founding fathers founded our country so that we could not have dictatorial powers in the hands of one person. Okay? You cannot have any person in this country with power. Their power must be checked by a committee or their peers or the voters. Their power must be checked. If the sheriff can ban any gun he wants, that's fine, because we'll vote the sheriff out. But if an appointed person that is not elected has that power, he is a dictator. He is not obligated to obey anybody. He's an appointed figure. And I would not take that power. If you came to me and said, Vinny, I'm going to grant you the power to ban any gun you want, I would refuse. I would refuse. I have had people offer to give me their passwords to access their YouTube accounts to check things for them. I refuse the power. Because I, like George Washington, am uncomfortable with power. George Washington surrendered his sword after the British left America. He went to the Congress and surrendered his sword. Years later, after serving two terms as president, they demanded he run again. And he would have been undefeatable again. He said, no, I will step aside. I will not hold power. I've been in power 8 years. I will not be in power again because that is a dictator. I will not hold power. And I will not. I will never accept power. I don't like power. I'm uncomfortable with it. I don't like power. You're my subordinate. If you don't like me, quit. But I will not accept power over you like a dictator. I refuse the power. So would my cousin. So that's the issue. There have been guns confiscated. Power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. That fuckhead Paul Humpke said publicly after Fast and Furious, he said this shit. Give the ATF more power. The ATF isn't corrupt enough now. Let's give him more power to help him out. Hitler wanted more power. I'm going to tell you something about Hitler. Hitler had a government building. You remember Star Wars, the prequel series? Emperor Chancellor Palpatine gets more and more power. Okay? On one side, Chancellor Palpatine is fighting to save the Republic. On the other side, his alter ego, Darth Sidious, is fighting to destroy the Republic. And he's trying to keep power and he becomes emperor. That's modeled after Adolf Hitler. There was a building called the Reichschancellery that was burned. And after it was burned, Hitler blamed the communists, the Jews, the this, the that. And Hitler said, because the communists and the Jews and the subhumans burned our building, you must give me more power, that way I can protect you. And they did. The last free will, the last free act the German people committed before the end of World War II was to give Hitler uncontrollable power. And it is believed that Hitler himself set that building on fire because he wanted to create a problem, that way he could help solve it and get more power. Gun confiscation violates my right to keep and bear arms. And I cannot get over that between New York City and California, that was not brought to federal court. NRA, Second Amendment Foundation, they weren't as powerful then as they are now, the organizations, but I cannot get over that was not brought to federal court. Okay, thank you. Goodbye.